Data Dictionary, teacher details for a school database. Now, in the previous videos, we've looked at a schematic diagram of a relational database that could be used to develop classes at a school. And we looked at a variety of different entities there, student, teachers, subjects, classrooms, a whole variety of entities that make up that wider relational database. Today, we're going to have a look at one of those entities, specifically the teacher entity. And basically what kinds of fields would be in that entity if you were going to do either a flat file database of a teacher database on its own or this wider relational database that we've been looking at in these previous videos. So let's first look at the fields that would be in this data dictionary. So firstly, we would have teacher ID, and teacher ID, of course, would be our primary key. It would be the main identifier of each teacher, a specific code that highlights each unique teacher. So its data type would likely be text. We're going to make it 4 digits long, okay? It's going to be 4 letters, and that's why I've got 4 X's there, okay? And it's a unique identification for all teachers. An example could be CKAL, and that's a similar system that I've used in previous schools where you got the first name of the teacher represented in one character, and then the first 3 letters of their last name all combined to make their teacher code. The other fields that we might have in this data dictionary for teachers include their first name, their last name, their title, subjects taught, and level. Okay, and we'll explore what these more mean. So firstly, for their first name, it's going to be obviously a text. Okay, we'll give it a maximum amount of characters of 20 characters. We don't need to provide a format because there could be a whole range of different texts we could expect. And my name, for example, might go in as Chris. For last names, pretty much the exact same thing. Okay, so it's going to be text once again. We'll give it 20 characters in length maximum. It's going to be the teacher's surname. And an example could be Lim. Title obviously would be whether they are a male or female teacher. And, you know, Mr., Mrs., Miss, Ms., Doctor. There's a whole variety of titles a teacher can be given. Okay. The longest one I can think there would might be a Miss with a dot on the end. And that would be 5 characters in length. So I've made my field size 5 there. Okay. And that obviously is the title of the teacher. Now, the next actual field is the subjects taught. Now, we need to give a bit of length to this one because we might be putting in a variety of subjects here. So I've made it the field size 50 characters in length and is the subjects the teacher teaches. Okay, so an example could be they teach technology and mathematics, and we put it all in this section of our data dictionary. And then finally is the level of the teacher, because obviously we do have standard teachers, but then we also have teachers appointed certain positions such as year coordinators, subject coordinators, principal, executive assistants. Okay, so it's the position the teacher is. Okay, an example we have here is a classroom teacher down as that. So pretty much this is a straightforward data dictionary. Everything is text, and because everything is text, I don't need to provide any data formats outside of the actual teacher ID itself because it is our primary key. Otherwise, this is another example of a data dictionary, and I hope it helps you in your understanding of data dictionaries.